Hi, thanks for your interest regarding this tutorial on Driver Assist. The first question you might have is, what is Driver Assist and what can it do for my PC? The answer is simple. It's a tool that you can use to quickly and easily update the drivers on your computer in order to make sure that all of your hardware is up to date and running at peak performance. At the top of the window, you'll notice several tabs. The License tab, the Home tab, the Restore tab, the Settings tab, and the Scan Now tab. We'll start at the License tab. Here we'll take note at the top of the window where the Driver Assist License Info states the program is in fact registered. Below that, you'll see the product version, the user ID in the white box, the license key in the black box, and the expiration date, which notes when you'll need to renew your subscription to Driver Assist. Just below that, you can see who the program is registered to, as well as the corresponding email address. In the Home tab, we'll take notice of a few things going on here. At the top left corner of the window, you can see a status indicator along with a section denoting the last time of your scan. Next to that, on the right side of the window, you'll notice a small color key denoting the various statuses of drivers that might need addressing. In the center, you'll see a Scan Now button. Let's not press that just yet, as we're still setting up. In the lower left corner of the window, you'll see the system info. This will note your operating system. Windows 10 here, but Windows XP, Vista, 7, 8, and 8.1 will also work just as fine. Your processor, the current version of DirectX that your system is running, your computer's name, the amount of RAM or memory, as well as the brand and type of motherboard you have. On to the Restore tab. Here's where the backup or restore points are created and stored for easy access and use. The purpose of a restore point is fairly simple. Let's say you recently scanned your system and then applied the recommended fix to the driver issues that were found. But whoops, you accidentally removed an older driver that you found works better than a newer one. That happens once in a while, even if it is rare. But you think, you're out of luck, right? Well, not really. If you created a restore point before you applied the fix, all you have to do is access it in this tab, click on the button next to the desired restore point, and follow along with the prompts in that process. Your system will be restored to that point when the older driver was still active. Then you can rescan, select that particular driver to be ignored by the fix, and update the remaining drivers as desired. Next, we'll head to the Settings tab. Here, we have three subtabs: General Settings, Scheduled Scans, and Backup and Restore. Under the General Settings tab, we first note the scan settings. Here, we can choose from a list of items to be scanned or ignored, as well as whether or not we want to automatically select all items to be fixed after a scan. You'll also see the application settings. Here, you can choose to run the program when the computer turns on, or not to do that at all, as well as whether or not you want to be notified each time you close the program. A checkmark box means that choice is active, but only if you save the settings before exiting this subtab. To the right, you'll see a list of languages you can choose from. Just under this, we have the update settings. Here we can decide if we want the program to scan our system as soon as it starts, or not. Below that is the new folder that the drivers will be saved into. You can easily select a different location by clicking on the Browse button right next to that destination, and then clicking on the folder or subfolder that you wish to save the new drivers into. Or you can create a new folder altogether for that process. The Connection Retry Timeout settings will tell the program how long to wait before reattempting a driver download when there are connection issues, as well as how many times to try before giving up. Finally, we can choose whether we want to be prompted to restart the computer after the new drivers are installed, and if we want the program to download those drivers automatically. In all of these cases, as stated earlier, a checkmark box means that choice is active, but only if you save the settings before exiting this subtab. In the Scheduled Scan subtab, we can select the type of schedule we want. We can run it once and select the time and date. We can run it every day, where we can just select the time. Every week, where we can select the time and any day or days of the week we want. Or we can decide to schedule no scan at all and just manually initiate a scan as we see fit. Now onto the Backup and Restore subtab. Here, we can choose to automatically create a backup before repairing. We can have the program ask us if we want to backup, or we can decide not to backup at all. I don't recommend this last option unless you happen to be an advanced computer user. Personally, I would recommend the auto backup option. Now we can start the scan. We can either select the Scan Now tab, or we can go into the Home tab and hit that big green button we saw earlier. Both options will do the same thing. Let's start the scan. As you can see here, we do have some drivers that need to be updated. They are also automatically selected. So we can either go down to update the selected drivers, which is the lower green button, or we can go to update all. Let's click that. As you can see, the drivers have been downloaded and we can install them. We can either install selected drivers or we can install all of the drivers. In some cases, we may need to do a manual install if the automatic install fails. If that needs to happen, we'll show you exactly what to do. As you can see, the drivers are being backed up. This may take a little while depending on the speed of your system and the size of the drivers that need to be backed up. And as you can see, our drivers did fail to automatically install. This being the case, we can do a manual install as necessary. We can either install the drivers manually individually, or we can do all of them in a row using the green button down below. Let's use the green button. As you can see, the drivers are being prepared and they will install shortly. An Explorer window will pop up showing you where the drivers are being installed. Don't worry, you don't actually need to access this, it's just for your convenience. This will happen several times over. Let's fast forward the process now. Now that we've scanned the system and fixed the driver issues, we can either rescan to make sure there are no remaining issues, or we can head back to the Home tab. And that's Driver Assist in a nutshell. If you need any help beyond what's in this tutorial, feel free to call the number to the 24/7 live help hotline located in the upper right-hand corner of the window, or click the Help button in the lower left-hand corner of the window. This will open a live chat window, as well as a ticket that you can enter the necessary information into, submit, and then just wait for a response. Thanks so much for checking out this tutorial on Driver Assist. If you have any time, please feel free to also check out the other tutorials on Total System Care and SafeBytes. Thanks, and have a great day!